Yeah, good morning, everyone. We had seen that the US market saw some correction yesterday. From the bottom, it has bounced back in the US as well. Nasdaq was majorly impacted, mainly because of tech stock. A lot of Chinese company which are listed on the Nasdaq got hammered yesterday. And that was the continuation of what has happened in Hong Kong and China. Yesterday, wherein Hong Kong index was down by over 4%, mainly led by regulation changes threat from China, which is imposing some restrictions on the Chinese tech company or ad tech company listed on Hong Kong. So this has had an impact on the Nasdaq as well. So futures are more of a flat, and Asian markets are more of a mixed bag. Japan is down, but other markets are showing some positiveness. Whereas in the commodities are more of a flattish. Oil is at near $75, and aluminium down by around 1. Copper is flat. Iron ore is up by around 0.7%, and steel is down by around 0.84%. The steel got impacted from the news yesterday that the China may import-export duty on the steel exported from China, which will bring down the prices in China. But this can act positive for the other countries' steel exporters and can act positive for them, as Chinese supply in the international market will reduce, and that will support the company which are exporting in the international market, like from India. So that can act as positive for a steel company in India. So now I request the technical team to take up first.
Very good morning, everyone. This is Ayush Mehta. I'll be taking the call for the day. By taking the cues from the global markets, we feel Nifty is going to open on a flattish note. Like we have seen a huge selling pressure in the market yesterday. Today, we feel it's going to be a volatile trading session. Whereas if Nifty starts moving upwards, and then the first resistance for Nifty is currently placed at 15,840. And if we see a closing on that, then there's going to be a next resistance at 15,920. Whereas immediate support for Nifty for today is placed at 15,670, followed by 15,600, 15,500 mark. Again, it is going to be a very volatile session, so we request everyone to trade with strict stop losses. Moving on to Bank Nifty, the immediate resistance for the day is currently placed at 35,100. And if we witness a closing above that, then the next resistance is currently placed at 35,380. Whereas, if Bank Nifty starts falling, then the immediate support for Bank Nifty is currently placed at 34,600, followed by 34,430. Moving on to Nifty Financial Services, it gave a closing of 16,646. The immediate resistance for today is placed at 16,750, followed by 16,870. Whereas the immediate support for Nifty Financial Services is 16,570 and 16,500. Manappuram and Pfizer looks good at the current level, and there was a huge selling pressure in the pharma stocks yesterday because of the bad results. Dr. Reddy, Alembic Pharma, and we feel AU Bank looks good at the current level. One can have a long position for a target of 1240 with a stop loss of 1156. We have initiated a buy call on this. That's all from my side. I request derivatives guys to take the call forward.
Yeah, thank you, Ayush. See, on the derivative front, again, now we are near the expiry, and looking at the overall rollovers as well up till date, it is, average. There is nothing major that has come out from the rollovers till now. Open interest continues to be low. The PCR OI has fallen sharply yesterday from 1.1 odd to about 0.9. And it is near the oversold zone. Again, as Nifty has been trading in a range of 15,650 and 15,950, Nifty is near its lower band. So once it comes below, you know, below the 15,700 levels or near the 15,650 levels, it comes into the buy zone. So we would advise to buy around those areas because it has been the range in the last 6 or 7 weeks. Some good amount of open interest built up has been seen around the 15,700, 15,500 put strikes. So for this expiry, these two will be good support areas. And it will be unlikely to break, at least for now, unless some data changes. The VIX continues to remain, consolidated in a range from 11.5. It has risen to 13.5, but nothing major actually. 13 is still very comfortable levels for the VIX. Once it goes above 15, that is when, along with that, if a breakdown comes in, that means, you'll see some aggressive selling, but at this point of time, there's nothing of that sort happening. From the stock specific front, yesterday, pharma stocks did witness a lot of selling. And these stocks, the open interest has actually moved up that, and the shorts are getting covered as well. Some profit booking is going on as well. So it is a good sign. I believe these stocks will bounce back. So the likes of Lupin, Dr. Reddy, they might consolidate for a month or so. But open interest is not very alarming. And that is the only reason why one should be buying on dips. That's it from my side. I'd like to ask the fundamental team to continue.
Good morning. IndusInd Bank result was it. So IndusInd continues to post the highest slippage ratio at 5.2%. Almost 2/3 of these slippages were from commercial vehicles and microfinance segments. Restructured book increased from 2% to 2.7%. Although credit cost will decline from last year's 3.8% mark, but it will still remain around 3%. And so there will be limited scope for ROE expansion in the current year. We are neutral on the stock. IIFL Finance improved GNPA, increased slightly from 2% to 2.2%. Although when we see the collection efficiency levels, the segment of small business loan and MFI were at 84% in quarter one. The company actually utilized their provisions, contingent provisions, which they had created last year. That is why we are seeing the negative figure on the provisioning side. So we are positive on this company. Dixon Technologies result was below expectation, mainly because of margin pressure. Because this quarter, the sales mix of televisions was much higher than historical levels. And this being on the OEM model front, the margins are lower over here. Company has given a guidance of 11.5 to 12,000 crores for current year against 6,500 crores in FY21. It's a stable company, and even from current levels, we feel that one can generate 25% kind of compounded returns from here. So we are positive here. Today there will be an IPO opening, IPO of Rolex Rings Limited, which is an auto ancillary company, and it will be closing on Friday. We have a subscribe rating on it. The price band is 880 rupees to 900 rupees. Issue size is 731 crores, of which OFS is 675 crores and fresh issue of 56 crores. Now, this is an auto ancillary where 60% of sales are coming from bearing rings, which are mainly used in making bearings. Almost 20% of every bearing cost, comprises of these inner and outer rings, where its main customers are all high quality bearing companies like SKF, NRB, Timken, Schaeffler. So if you notice, all these MNC bearing companies make good ROC and trade at high valuations. So you feel Rolex should not be simply looked at as a plain vanilla auto ancillary company, but one which is catering to these set of clients. Apart from the bearing rings, almost remaining 40% of revenue comes from normal auto parts like wheel hubs, gears, and shafts, which is more like the other ancillary companies. So we feel the valuations are in line with most of the auto ancillary players. But we do feel that it should command some premium because of the revenue share which it caters to the MNC bearing players. So based on that, we have given a subscribe rating to the IPO. That's it from my side.
Good morning, everyone. Yesterday, Dr. Reddy announced the results, and results were below expectation, and we saw the sharp movement in yesterday's trade. Also, the stock was down almost 10%. Another reason for this decline was that there was news that there was some complaint against the company in the US, and it can impact their future prospects because of this. However, the management clarified during the con call that it is nothing serious, and they have already got this kind of a complaint in last year, and they are looking into it. So we believe, and also the margins were disappointing this quarter, where it came at 18% versus expectation of 23%. However, the management believes that it was impacted because of higher price erosion and higher inventory provisions, but this is likely to improve going forward due to the full realization of products launched in US in recent past, and also because of scale up of API activities. So we believe we expect some positive reversal in today's trade on Dr. Reddy. TTK Prestige announced the results, and results have improved. Sales grew by 77% YOY on weak or muted base. EBITDA margins came at 11% versus 3% last year. The stock is trading at 48 times FY22 EPS. Morpen Laboratories announced the results, and results have improved. Sales grew YOY and Q&Q, and margins also improved YOY and Q&Q. The stock is trading at 29 times TTM EPS. Greenlam Industries announced the results, and results were in line with the expectations. Sharda CropChem announced their results, though it is a seasonally weak quarter, and Q4 is their main key quarter. However, this quarter also the company expected reported good results. Sales grew by 60% YOY, and EBITDA margins were 16.5% versus 12% last year. It is trading 13 times, and it is not expensive at this point of time. Sanofi announced their results, and results have improved. Sales grew by 11%, and margins were positive surprise at 31% versus 25% last year. And stock is trading 28 times FY22 EPS. This is one of the good stocks and in MNC pharma space, and we are positive on this. Granules announced their results, and results were above expectations. Sales grew by 15%, and margins were higher than expectation at 24% versus 22%. Last year, though, it was 25%. But given the scenario of higher API prices and all, we believe this is good results, and we expect a positive reaction to the company in today's trade. Torrent Pharma announced the results, and results were mainly in line with the expectation. The sales was muted at around 2,134 crores. During the con call, the management said that the gross margins were a little lower in this quarter because of lower export benefits. And there was some one more effect, and they expect this to normalize in next quarter. And they have also repaid 350 debt from the cash flow. So we are positive and expect positive movement in this in today's trade. Aarti Drugs announced the results, and results were below expectations. Though the sales has grown 6% YOY, the margins were a major disappointment, which came at 13.7% versus expectation of 21. So we expect negative reaction in today's trade for Aarti Drugs. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Coforge has announced the result. The result is above expectation, with order intake coming in at $301 million. Order executable has also improved to $645 million. Dollar revenue came at $199 million, which is up 15.7% Q on Q. In this, organic growth is also good at coming in at 7.6%. EBITDA margins have dipped and came in at 14.5% versus Q on Q of 16.6%. Share is trading at 43.1 times FY22 EPS. Mahindra Logistics has posted above expectation numbers for the quarter, with revenue coming in at 873 crores versus expectation of 769 crores. EBITDA margins is also above expectation, coming in at 5.2%. Share is trading at 58.8 times FY22 EPS. Philatex India has posted declined set of numbers for the quarter, with revenue declining 18% Q on Q and EBITDA margins coming in at 14.5% versus Q on Q of 22.1%. Share is trading at 8.9 times TTM EPS. KPR Mill has posted okay set of numbers for the quarter, and the company has announced stock split from rupees 5 paid up to 5 share of rupees 1 paid up. Share is trading at 23.5 times FY22 EPS. Thank you.
Good morning. Dalmia Bharat came up with this result, and the result was in line with expectation. Volume came lower, but EBITDA per ton increased ahead of expectation. The share is trading at EBITDA of 12.47 times FY23 EBITDA. Ramco Cements reported mixed set of results for the quarter. Disappointing on account of strict lockdown in Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Karnataka. The impact of lower volume was offset by a sharp increase in realization, which came in at rupees 5739 million ton, up by 13% Q on Q. Normalcy has returned in July month, and the demand has picked up in infra and commercial segment, except in Kerala, where demand still continues. Going forward, profitability can improve, driven by higher cement prices. Godavari Power and Ispat came up with the result, and the result has grew up by 22% Q on Q. The margins were... Margins came in at 51% versus 8% quarter on quarter. The company has repaid all its long-term loans and currently is debt-free on standalone basis. Management has approved the proposal for payment of an interim dividend of rupees 5 per share. Thank you.
So quite a few results, but I feel one can keep a watch on in small cap shares, Philatex and Sanofi. In fact, Philatex result was declining quarter on quarter. But what we see from here is that the results should start improving, and valuations even on declined result, that is of Q1 FY21. It's still trading at 3.5 time EV by EBITDA of Q1 annualized earning. Company is doing some expansion also, and company will be benefiting from new power plant which has just started. So around 20 crore of additional benefit will be coming in each quarter. So results can improve from here. So one can work on this. Only important thing here is that one should keep a stop loss, as it's more of a commodity item. And if suppose commodity prices start declining, then can have a negative impact. So with some minor stop loss, one can look to invest in this stock. Apart from that, Sanofi also came up with good number, but the performance came in the trading hours, but the result has not got full reflection on the prices, but possibility is there that this stock can also show some positive trend in today's trade. Apart from that, results for results for 30th July. Bharat Heavy Electronics Electricals is likely to report number, and numbers are likely to be weak. they are likely to consistently report losses at the EBITDA level, which was the case even in the best quarter, that is the fourth quarter also they reported the EBITDA loss. So that is likely to continue even in this quarter. So result is likely to be weak. Then Exide industry is likely to report number. Here again, margin quarter on quarter is likely to come down by around 200 basis points, and revenue is also likely to decline by 18%. So more of a impact of lockdown, and result will be showing some declining trend. IOC is likely to report number, and this also result is likely to show some decline. Quarter on quarter margin is expected to come up from 11% to around 6.7%, and revenue quarter on quarter is likely to show around 4% growth. Then Kansai Nerolac is likely to report numbers. We had seen that the Asian Paint result was below expectations, but outlook whatever given by the Asian Paint was quite positive. So same thing can get reflected in Kansai Nerolac as well, though the result may be weak, but the outlook from here is positive for these paint companies because of the price increase which they had already taken and are taking currently. Then Merico Industry is likely to report number, and numbers are likely to show improvement both on margin. Quarter on quarter margin is likely to show improvement from 16% to 20%. In fact, last quarter has some negative impact, and that's why the margin came off. But normalized margin for the company is at around 19.5 to 20%, and that is likely to revert back. The key thing is that the revenue is also likely to show growth both quarter on quarter and year on year. So year on year revenue is likely to grow by 30% and quarter on quarter by around 24%. So overall Merico Industries result is likely to be positive. Sun Pharma industry is likely to report number. We had seen that Dr. Reddy had seen pricing pressures in the US market. So quite possible similar thing may be visible in even Sun Pharma also. The expectation is that the result is likely to be more of a flattish type of result, with revenue growth of around 3% quarter on quarter, and EBITDA margin is likely to remain stable. Then V-Guard is likely to report number. We had seen that the Crompton Greaves reported below expectation number, whereas Havells has reported above expectation results. So the trend shown by the previous companies are mixed bag. Let us see how V-Guard get impacted. In fact, lockdown in southern part, which is the key market for V-Guard, was higher impacted this time. So quite possible V-Guard may report results below expectations. Then Britannia is likely to report number. And Britannia is likely to report numbers, and numbers are likely to be more of a flattish. Quarter on quarter revenue growth of around 1.3%, and EBITDA margin is also around, will improve by around 100 basis points from 16% to 17%. But year on year, the trend will be lower. As last year, same time, there was a pantry loading which has happened for the biscuits and all. So that pushed up the result in the last year. So year on year, it is showing declining trend. Then Finolex Industries is likely to report numbers. Numbers are likely to get impacted because of the declining PVC prices and also declining consumptions in the rural area this time. We had seen that the Supreme Industry had shown the decline in the demand for PVC pipe even quarter on quarter and year on year also. So same thing can be visible in the Finolex industry also. And even EDC PVC, which is the second division for them, the EDC PVC spread has declined. So that can also have a negative impact. So overall Finolex industry result is likely to show declining trend. Jindal Saw is likely to report better number, as pellet prices has moved up a lot, and a lot of profitability is coming because of that. And we had seen the same in Godavari Power result as well. So same thing can get reflected in Jindal Saw as well. So result is likely to be positive for Jindal Saw. JK paper is likely to report number, and we had seen that the ITC paper division has shown good results. So quite possible JK paper can also report better number, as pulp prices internationally has moved up higher, and JK paper is backwardly integrated. So quite possible JK paper may benefit because of that. JSW energy result is likely to show up higher, as quarter on quarter revenue is likely to move up by around 35% because of the hydro division, which is doing, which is maybe benefiting in this quarter. And EBITDA margin is also likely to remain stable, but EBITDA quarter on quarter is likely to show upward trend. So overall result is likely to show positive trend. KEC International result is likely to show declining trend. Dr. Reddy laboratory results is likely to show positive trend in this quarter. Then PI industry is likely to report number. Here the numbers are likely to show positive trend. Quarter on quarter revenue is likely to grow by around 11% and year on year by 25%, and margin is also likely to show positive trend. Last quarter reported 19%, but this quarter it is expected at around 22.5%. So result is likely to be good. And Prakash Pipe, again, PVC companies are not likely to show good result and can get impacted in this quarter. Then UPL is likely to report number, and numbers are likely to show some positive trend year on year. This is more of a seasonally off quarter for UPL. Q4 is the best quarter. From Q4, the trend will be lower, but year on year, margins are likely to expand by around 80 bips and revenue is likely to grow by around 10%. So overall trend is likely to be positive. Jyoti Lab declining result is expected. Then PVR is there, which is also likely to continue to get impacted. Shopper Stop result is also likely to get impacted because of the lockdown. Union Bank of India result is there, and that is also getting impacted because of the lockdown and increasing credit cost in this quarter. Vardhman Textile is likely to benefit from increasing yarn prices, cotton yarn prices. So that's all from us. Thank you very much and have a good day.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel for in-depth interviews of India Inc. and press the bell icon so that you do not miss our updates.